enough.
My whole background with climbing in the country of Spain has always been in Catalonia. But in all honesty, that's just, you know, one province of Spain. Catalonia is one province. There's many provinces of Spain, and Andalusia is widely known for having some of the best climbing in the world. I had this gap of time available, so I said, hey, why not check out the spot where my buddy Primo's climbing and see what's up? I got in touch with my buddy Primo, and we go and check out Villanueva del Rosario, which happened to be probably the most impressive cliff I think I've ever seen. I'd have to say it's the most top quality limestone ever, with colonnettes, sealed tight, blocky, weird, you know, angled stone that has, you know, this like coating of like a veneer or something that's like impenetrable. That was my intro to Andalusia, that little dose of like the best quality limestone I think I've ever seen in my life. Dos, tres, cuatro. Showing me pictures of high-end where we are now, and you know, he kept claiming that he has, you know, a project there. He just wants to finish this one route, and you know, it's amazing. You know, in this situation, I was just like, hey, I'm gonna take the back seat. I'm gonna go with the flow. I'm not gonna fight it, and just go. You know, like a lot of this trip for me has just been kind of just allowing things to roll. I think every time I've traveled to Spain, I leave with like one route, at least one route, one little diamond. I don't know, I could leave now. You know, I've been here for 2 weeks. I could leave now after having climbed the route sex after climb. This is definitely a dime piece route. It's on par with like some of the best routes I've ever climbed. It's all blue. It's an obvious blue pathway up this massive wall that's overhanging about 35 degrees, 30 degrees. You get knee bars, rests. It's like this pretty involved long route with, you know, this long section of hard climbing at the top. I will sometimes still underestimate, you know, how challenging an endurance route can be. And this is a perfect example of an endurance route where, you know, you climb probably like an 8B route to, you know, have to, you're resting your way all the way up the climb, and then it's just like this banger crux. It's like agujeros, these pockets where, you know, they chuss your fingers up. I like that blood for like, you know, every single time I try the route.
walk around. Do you feel like a reptile? Or when you really put your jaws on to them, is it hard not to crack a smile?
Timing's funny like that. You can't always predict it, what when your successes will happen. But I know this, when I'm climbing here in Spain, and I'm climbing here with, like, you know, the Españoles, the people, my whole energy for climbing changes. And ego is different. I don't have one. I have none. I go with intent, with the same mode that these people do. And I love that because it's really pure. Every time I come here, I leave with this new perspective, and I always bring that back home with me to my own projects and my own climbing-related life. And sometimes it's bigger than just climbing-related life. I bring it back to the way I go about my entire world. You know, it's just one of the reasons I travel to Spain specifically so often, is that I really dig the culture here, and I really dig the people. And of course, the climbing is the best in the world. But, you know, become a part of my life, and I like it that way. I'll probably keep it that way.
He's not letting us pay a dime, and we've been in here for almost 5 hours, eating and drinking. That goes from, like, when we got in here to a beer, to, like, drinking beer, to, like, having food, to, like, dessert, and more drinks, and, like, everybody hanging out with him.
He won't let us pay.
I like this guy, man. He's really cool. I don't know. We've been in here, like, every night. I've been here for 4 days. We've been in here every night.